Hello children, a very good morning to everyone. So welcome back to our grade 4 computer science online class. So children, we are dealing with the lesson 1, that is data storage and memory. So in the last class we have discussed about the types of computer memory, isn't it ma? So there are how many types of computer memory? Yes, there are 3 types of computer memory. What are they? Primary memory, then read-only memory, and last one is a secondary memory. Okay, primary memory, read-only memory and secondary memory. So today we are going to see some examples of secondary memory. Okay, we are going to see some examples for secondary memory. So listen, first example is floppy disk. Okay, floppy disk. So this floppy disk is a device. Okay, it's a secondary storage device. It consists of magnetic disk. It consists of what? Magnetic disk, and it is a square shaped device. Okay, it's a square shaped device and is used for storing the data. Okay, what's the use of this floppy disk? To store the data. Okay, and also we can able to transfer the data from one computer to the another computer. So by using the floppy disk, we can able to store the data and we can able to transfer the data from one computer to the another computer. Okay, and this floppy disk consists of two sizes. Okay, two sizes of floppy disk are there. First one is 3 1/2 inches of floppy disk, and second one is the 5 1/4 inches of floppy disk. Okay, so if you want to use this floppy disk, means we need a floppy disk drive in our computer. Okay, if you want to use this floppy disk, means we need what ma? Floppy disk drive in our computer. Okay, so floppy disk is an early day secondary storage device. Okay, it's an early secondary storage device. So by replacing this floppy disk, nowadays we are using CD, DVDs, pen drive, like this secondary storage device. Okay ma, the next one is a hard disk. Second example for the secondary storage device is what ma? Hard disk. So in the hard disk, there are two type of hard disk are there. First one is internal hard disk and second one is external hard disk. So internal hard disk, it is inside the CPU. So all the computer has an internal hard disk. Okay, it is placed inside the computer CPU. Okay, this hard disk is a part of unit called hard disk drive. Okay, so if you want to use this hard disk, means we need what? Hard disk drive inside the CPU, and it is also used to store large amount of data. So we can able to store large amount of data, like we can use 500 GB of data, 1 TB of data, and also 2 GB of data by using the internal hard disk. Okay, this hard disk is made up of collection of disk called platters. Okay, this hard disk is made up of collection of disk called platters, and these platters are placed one above the other. The platters are placed one below the other, and it is covered with a magnetic metal. Okay, it is covered with what? Magnetic metal. Each platters consists of a number of invisible concentric circle called tracks. So this platters consist of invisible circle called as tracks, and these tracks are further divided into sectors. And have you understood this? So next one is external hard disk. Okay, external hard disk. This external hard disk is not inside the CPU. We can able to connect with the computer. Okay, so external hard disk is not inside the CPU. We can able to connect through the computer with the help of USB. Okay, this external hard disk also we can able to store large amount of data, and also we can able to transfer data from one computer to the another computer. Okay, the next example. Okay, the third example for the secondary storage device is CD. CD, okay, this is a very normal thing we are using the nowadays, isn't it ma? CDs. See, what's the full form for CD, do you know? Yes, compact disc. Okay, compact disc. So this device also able to used to store large amount of data. So by using this CD, we can able to store 700 MB of data. Okay, don't forget. So we can able to store 700 MB of data in the CD. And this CD also consists of tracks and sectors like the hard disk. Okay, and this CD is also called a CD-ROM. Okay, CD-ROM. So what's the full form for CD? Compact disk. So fully you can say it is compact disk read-only memory. Okay, compact disk read-only memory. And the CD consists of two types. Okay, like the hard disk, CD also consists of two types. First one is CDR. Okay, CDR, and second one is CDRW. Okay, CDR means compact disk recordable. Compact disk recordable. So using this compact disk recordable, we can able to write the data. That means we can able to read the data in the CD and we can't able to erase it. Okay. So data once if you return on it means we can't able to erase from the CDR. Okay. And next one CDRW. The full form for CDRW is compact disc rewritable. Compact disc rewritable. So from the name itself we can able to say by using this CD we can able to write the data on it and we can able to erase it. Okay. Once it is record we can able to erase it and we can able to use it more times by using this CDRW. Okay. It is an erasable CD. Okay. And next third example for the secondary storage device is the DVD. Okay. DVD. We all know, isn't it? What is DVD? The full form for DVD is digital versatile disc. Okay. Digital versatile disc. So it is also like the CD. So when you are looking on the CD and DVD, it's very difficult to differentiate. Okay. So it is also similar to the CD only. Okay. So DVD means one more. The full form for DVD is a digital versatile disc. It's similar to the CD, but the storage capacity of the DVD is more than the CD. Okay. So in the CD we can able to store only 700 MB of data only, but in the DVD we can able to store about 4.7 GB of data. Okay. 4.7 GB. GB means what ma? Gigabyte of data we can able to store in the DVD. And the DVD we can able to store the video files. Okay. To using this DVD we can able to store the video files. Okay. And if you want to use this DVD means we need what ma? DVD drive. Okay, like the hard disk everything, here also we need what ma? DVD drive in our computer. Okay, have you understood ma? So CD means compact disk. It can able to store about 700 MB of data. There are two types of CD, that is CDR and CDRW. Okay, CDR means compact disk recordable. CDRW means compact disk rewritable. Next one. DVD, that is digital versatile disk. Here we can able to store large amount of data like 4.7 GB of data. It is also look similar to the CD. And next one is the fourth secondary storage device is Blu-ray disk. Okay, Blu-ray disk. This Blu-ray disk also looks similar to CD and DVD, but the storage capacity of the Blu-ray disk is 25 MP of data. So CD is 700 GB of data, DVD 4.7 GB of data, Blu-ray disc here we can able to store 25 GB of data. So next fifth example for the secondary storage device is flash drive. Okay, flash drive, otherwise commonly we will say it as pen drive. Okay, flash drive or pen drive. Okay, flash drive or pen drive. So this pen drive has a various storage capacity. Okay, so a pen drive has various storage capacity like 4 GB of data we can able to store, 8 GB, 16 GB, 32 GB, 64 GB, up to 1 TB of data we can able to store by using this pen drive. Okay, and also by using the pen drive we can able to transfer our data from one computer to another computer. So like the other CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc, this pen drive also we can able to store the data and we can able to transfer the data from one computer to another computer. And also by using this pen drive we can able to read, write and delete the data. That means erase the data also. Okay, so by using the pen drive we can able to read, write and delete the data from the computer system. And then the pen drive is very easy to use, isn't it ma? So pen drive is very easy to use and it is a small enough to carry around. We can able to carry this pen drive in our pocket itself. It's a very small thing, isn't it? It's very smaller than the pen. So we can able to carry it very easily in our pocket itself. And it is a very popular storage device. Okay, ma? Have you understood this? And the last example for the secondary storage device is SD card. Okay, SD card. It is used to store data in a portable devices such as digital cameras, musical player, cellular phone and e-book reader. Okay, so this SD cards we are using in the devices like digital cameras, then musical player, cellular phones and e-book reader. Okay, and the size of the SD card is very small. Okay, it's like similar to the postal stamps. Okay, we are using the postal stamp, no? Like that size only we have the SD card, okay ma, and this SD card can be store the capacity of data like 4 GB, 8 GB, then 16 GB, etc. So you can either insert this SD card in the SD port of your computer, otherwise you can insert this SD card in your SD card reader. Okay, so we can able to insert this SD card in the SD card port of the computer, otherwise the SD card reader. Okay, this SD card reader is then inserted in the computer to read the data on the card. So this SD card reader, then it have to insert in a computer to read the data on the card. Have you understood my this? So we have completed this lesson. So in this lesson we have learned about the data and information. So in my first one, data and information. So data means what ma? Data is the input device. Data is the input device we will give to the computer. Okay, don't forget, data is a given as a input to the computer, and information is the output we will get from the computer. Okay, and next we learned about the data storage unit. Is in data storage unit. So computer is working under the two digits. Okay, only two digits, that is 0 and 1. This 0 and 1 digit is called as a binary digit. Okay, so computer can able to understand the binary digits only, that is 0 and 1. And bit is a smaller unit of data. Okay, bit, bit, bit is a smallest unit of data. So we know that bit is a very smallest unit of data, isn't it? Bit is a very smallest unit of data. 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, isn't it, ma? So 8 bits is equal to 1 byte. Then 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 byte. Then 1 megabyte is equal to 1024 kilobyte. Next one, 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 megabyte. Then 1 terabyte is equal to 1024 gigabyte, isn't it? So likewise we learned about the types of memory, isn't it? There are 3 types of computer memories are there, that is primary memory. Otherwise we will say it as the random access memory, isn't it? Random access memory or volatile memory. Okay, volatile memory. So primary memory has more than 3 or 4 names: primary memory or main memory, random access memory, volatile memory. These are some names of the primary memory, isn't it? Then next we learned about the read only memory, that is ROM. Read only memory, what's the short form? ROM, isn't it? That is a non-volatile memory. And there are 3 types of ROM are there, that is PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Okay, these are 3 example of ROM: PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Then we have learned about the secondary memory with some examples, isn't it? So children, you have the book exercise in the page number 15. Okay, so look at the book exercise. First one, fill in the blanks with the correct words. So answers, everything is given in the box. Okay, so you have to take and write the correct answer in the particular box. Okay, the particular dash. So listen, first one, a byte is a unit of measuring computer memory. So what's the standard unit measure the computer memory? Byte. Okay, we know bit is a smaller one, but byte is the standard form of computer memory, measuring the computer memory. Okay, so byte is a unit of measuring computer memory. Byte is the unit of measuring computer memory. The next one, the dash drive is small, easy to use storage device that can be carried around in a packet. The dash device is small, easy to use storage device that can be carried around in your packet. So which one we can able to carry, ma? Flash drive, isn't it? Flash drive. Otherwise we can call this as pen drive. Okay, flash drive or pen drive. Next one, the dash is the non-volatile memory. The dash is a non-volatile memory. It's non-volatile memory. ROM, read only memory, is the non-volatile memory. Next one, the memory that lost its content when the power supply is turned off is called dash memory. The memory that lost its content when the power supply is turned off is called dash memory. Which memory, ma? Yes, volatile memory, otherwise primary memory. Okay, random access memory, more names are there. Okay, so our answer what is given? Volatile memory. Okay, so volatile memory will lose the data, last memory, everything, if the power supply of the computer is off, switched off. Okay, the next one, full form of ROM is dash. Full form of ROM is read only memory. The full form of ROM is read only memory. Understood this?
Then look at the next one, true or false. Write T for the true statement and F for the false one. P ROM and EP ROM are the type of ROM. Is it correct only? No, these two are the example of the ROM. So it's a, we have to write true. Okay, P ROM and EP ROM are types of ROM. Next, RAM is an example of non-volatile memory. RAM is an example of non-volatile memory. That's wrong, isn't it, ma? We already look at in the fill in the blanks. Primary memory is a volatile memory. It is given what, ma? Non-volatile memory. So it is false. Okay, false. Next one, the flash drive is very common storage device as it is easy to carry and use. This also we look at in the second fill up. So that is true only. Okay, the flash drive is very common storage device as it is easy to use and easy to carry and use. That is true. Next one, a CD, DVD and Blu-ray disc are round in shape. Yes, all these three devices are round in shape now. So true. Okay, next one, there are internal and external hard disk. Yes, we learned, isn't it? How many types of hard disk are there? Two types, that is internal hard disk and external hard disk. So true. So first one true, then false. True, true, true. Only one thing is false. Okay, so next we have the choose the correct option. Which of the following is not a ROM? Which of the following is not a ROM? So we know the types of ROMs are three types: P ROM, EP ROM, and EEP ROM. So it my P ROM, EP ROM, and EEP ROM. It is not in the. It is not a type of ROM, isn't it? So it's wrong. So we have to tick it the third option. Next one: which part of the computer is used to store the data or information? Which part of the computer is used to store the data and information? See the options: keyboard, mouse, internal hard disk, monitor. Yes, we know we can able to store data in the internal hard disk, isn't it? So second, third option is correct. Okay, first and second, third option is correct. Then third question, this device is generally used with the digital camera for storing data. This device is generally used with the digital camera for storing data. See the option: hard disk, SD card, credit card, CD. We know SD card only we are used to store the data in the digital camera. No, so option second one is correct. Okay, SD card is used in the digital camera to store the data. Next one, 1B data is equal to dash bit. 1B means what, ma? Byte, isn't it? 1B means byte. Okay, byte, we know B means byte. So 1 byte is equal to what? 8 bit. Okay, 8 bits. So option fourth one, 8 bit. 8 bit is equal to 1 byte. So last question we have, which of this is not a non-volatile memory? Okay, look at the not a non-volatile memory, which is the non-volatile memory, ma? ROM. Okay, read only memory. Okay, so you have to copy this book exercise in the page number 15. Okay, in the book exercise page number 15 you have to copy it. Okay, ma? Then we can see the booklet portion. So already I gave the three question answers, and ma, first three question answers we completed. Then fourth one, look at here. What are the three types of ROM? Also mention their full form. What are the three types of ROM? Also mention their full form. See the answer: programmable read only memory. Programmable read only memory. So in the bracket you have to write the short form, that is P ROM. Then second one, erasable programmable read only memory. Erasable programmable read only memory, that is EEPROM. The last one is electrically erasable programmable read only memory. Electrically erasable programmable read only memory, the short form is EEPROM. EEPROM. Okay, then next question, write 5 examples of secondary storage devices. Write 5 examples of secondary storage devices. The answer is hard disk, DVDs, Blu-ray disc, flash drives and SD cards are 5 examples of secondary storage devices. Hard disk, DVDs, Blu-ray disc, flash drives and SD card are 5 examples of secondary storage devices. So you have to copy this two question answers, okay, in your booklet. So when I send the PDF file for this question answers, you have to copy the question from the book. Okay, in page number 16 you have the questions, everything. So please see and copy the question from the book, and only next after only have to write the answers. Okay, down to the question only have to write the answers. Have you understood? Don't put the dots, otherwise without writing the question, don't write. Okay, write the question and write the answer. Okay, have you understood? Learn everything. First week of the August month, that is next month, the first week you will have the exam. Okay, the first midterm exam you will have. So prepare for that. Prepare for the exam. So we have completed the first lesson. So study well. Just simple lesson only. Only book and booklet portion. So 5 questions is there, isn't it, ma? So study well, and we can meet in the next class. Thank you so much. Bye.